Hey, Kev.
Hey, Dad.
What are you doing?
Just taking up the hem on Heather's dress.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, Dad, will you do me a favor and check my muffins?
Sure, killer.
Yeah, just stick a toothpick in one of them, and if it comes out clean, that means they're done.
Look, we never had that little man-to-man talk, did we, Kev?
No, Dad, I'm doing this for school. I'm taking home ec.
You are?
Look, Dad, it's an easy A. Besides, it was either this or wood shop, and I need all my fingers for college.
Hey, Mom, I'm somebody famous. Tell me who I am.
Raymond Burr.
No, I'm William Howard Taft. For a President's Day pageant at school, remember?
Oh, right. Gosh, you look wonderful, honey.
No, I don't. Nobody knows who I am, and even when I tell them, they don't know.
Well, President Taft. Home early from school?
Oh, you see, honey, Mr. Belvedere knows who you are.
Ah, he doesn't count. Mr. Belvedere knows everything.
That's true.
What's the matter, champ?
Wesley's a little upset about his President's Day pageant at school.
I got there late, and the only presidents left were Taft and Nixon, and Howie Huffnagel got to be Nixon because he sweats a lot.
Well, honey, we're very proud of you, no matter which president you are.
Yeah, cheer up, pal. You'll make George Washington next year.
I still might get to play Lincoln.
Oh, yeah?
You know my friend Danny O'Neill, the one you all like so much because he never does anything wrong? Well, he was supposed to play Lincoln, but his parents had to come and take him home.
Why?
He got caught with this stuff called AIDS.
AIDS?
Oh, my God.
Boy, he must really be in trouble.
Streaks on the china, never mattered before. Who cares when you drop-kicked your jacket as you came through the door? No one glares, but sometimes things get turned around and no one spared. All hands look out below, there's a change in the status quo. Gonna need all the help that we can get. According to our new arrival, life is more than mere survival. We just might live the good life yet.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I understand. Okay, thank you very much. Goodbye.
So what'd the school say?
Danny's got AIDS. It seems he told some kids on the playground, and they got scared and told some other kids, and Danny's parents were called, and I guess they decided the best thing would be to keep him home until the doctors can evaluate his case.
Well, what's he doing with AIDS? I mean, he's just a kid.
George, I believe the boy is a hemophiliac.
So?
Apparently, he got some infected blood a couple of years ago.
Well, doesn't anybody test that stuff?
They do now.
What about Wesley? He thinks that getting AIDS is like being caught with chewing gum. What are we going to tell him?
I say make something up.
Hi, guys. I'm going to go upstairs and do my homework now. See ya.
Hold it, Wes. There's something your mom and I'd like to talk to you about.
Is it serious?
I'm afraid so, honey.
Really? Serious?
Yeah, pal.
But I wasn't the one who wanted to play doctor. It was Holly Huffnagel's idea.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. What are you talking about?
About your friend Danny.
Listen, Wes, this AIDS thing you told us about. Do you know what that is?
Sure. I mean, it's real bad, and you get in real bad trouble if you get caught with it. Sort of like shoplifting.
That's pretty close. Wes, AIDS is a disease, and your friend is pretty sick.
Oh. So when's he gonna get better?
Nobody knows, champ.
Why not?
Well, Because the doctors haven't quite figured it all out yet. Do you understand?
You're saying you might be sick for a whole week?
Maybe two.
Boy, no school, Lucky Duck. Hey, guys.
Hey, Wes.
Hey, Wes.
Hey, Wesley. I heard you were getting to play President Lincoln now.
Yeah. If you give me a bite of your cupcake, I'll free
you. I don't need you. I'm playing Jimmy Carter, so aha.
The only reason you're getting to play Lincoln is because Danny got thrown out.
Yeah, I know. Anyway, I'm going over to Danny's house later. You guys want to come?
What's the matter?
Are you crazy? Do you want to die too?
What are you talking about?
That AIDS stuff is the worst thing you could get. I mean, you just get sicker and sicker. And then your arms and legs start falling off. And then it's all over and you're dead.
I am making all that up, Dennis.
I am not. My mom told me, and she's a beautician.
And my dad said to stay away from Danny, because you can get it real easy.
You can? Oh, yeah. You can get it by just touching somebody or drinking out of the same glass.
A sixth grader told me you can get it just by talking on the phone.
You guys are stupid.
You're just saying that because you're Danny's friend.
Yeah. You were his best friend. You guys did everything together.
So?
So you can have the rest of my cupcake.
See ya.
Kevin, what are you doing?
I'm trying to make a swan out of ground beef.
Is that anything like trying to make a silk purse out of a sow's ear?
No, I'm using beef. Anyway, I've got to fix dinner tonight, and everyone's supposed to give me a grade.
So, what's on the menu?
Oh, we've got meatloaf and peas, mashed potatoes, tapioca pudding for dessert.
Is this your salute to airline food?
Kevin, look at me.
Hey, you look great. What happened to your skirt?
You hemmed it like this.
Whoops.
Hi, guys.
Hey, honey.
Hello.
Where's Wes?
He's been upstairs taking a bath for over an hour.
Did he, say anything more about his friend Danny? Or about, you know, what he has?
You mean AIDS, Mom?
Thank you.
He hasn't said anything to me, but then I've been tied up.
Good evening, Mrs. Owens.
Ah, Mr. Belvedere. Will dinner be ready soon?
Personally, I think it was ready 20 minutes ago. But I'm not making it.
My meatloaf.
Oh. Hi, Mr. Belvedere.
Hello, Danny.
Is Wesley here?
Yes, come on in. Everyone, you remember Wesley's friend, Danny.
Oh, hi, Danny.
Hi, Mrs. Owens, Mr. Owens.
Hiya, champ. How's it going?
Well, I got AIDS, but other than that, I'm doing pretty good.
Wesley, your friend Danny's here.
Yeah, I see. Hi.
Hi.
I thought you were coming over today.
Something happened.
Oh, so was school. Okay, we had a substitute. They're getting me a tutor. At least until everybody figures out what to do with me. Me? Don't they let you downstairs?
Wesley.
Anyway, this is for you.
What is it?
It's my Lincoln costume. You're playing him now, right?
Yeah, right.
See, it's got the coat and the big hat and the beard and everything.
I don't want it.
It's okay. My mom washed it. Just stay away from me!
Hey, Wes!
Leave me alone!
Sorry.
I think we all handled that rather well.
What's the matter with that kid?
George, it's our fault.
Why? What did we do?
Nothing. I mean, Wesley had questions about Danny, and we just let him think everything was going to be okay. Now, I don't know what he's heard or where he's heard it, but obviously he's scared to death.
Well, we just got to talk to him and straighten everything out.
Is he gone?
Yeah, Wes, he went home.
He didn't touch anything, did he?
I don't believe so.
Good.
You know, Wes, that wasn't very nice the way you treated Danny just now.
So?
So I thought you guys were buddies.
We were, but I don't want to catch what he's got.
You're not going to.
That's not what my friends told me at school. I heard you can get it just by playing tag or swinging on the same swings.
Come on, Wes, you're talking dumb. I mean, you don't catch that stuff from just fooling around. I mean,
Wesley, what I think your father's trying to say is you don't catch AIDS by simply being around someone who has it. It requires a more intimate association.
You mean like dancing?
I mean, what I think Mr. Belvedere is trying to say is...
Wesley, what I think everybody is trying to say is the way you get AIDS is from sexual contact or using infected needles or getting contaminated blood products, which is how your friend Danny got it. You understand?
I think so.
Well, if you need to know anything else, I'll be upstairs.
You see, champ, being around Danny is not going to make you sick.
So how come all the other kids' parents are acting so scared?
Well, sometimes grown-ups don't have all the facts, and they love their kids, and they get a little nervous.
Oh, yeah?
I mean, they worry, because they know how kids are. You know, always roughhousing and getting little scratches and scrapes, sharing the same ice cream bar. You know what I mean?
Yeah, me and Danny did all that stuff.
You did?
Yeah. That's okay, isn't it?
Of course it is.
Yeah, sure it is, pal. Now, why don't you run on upstairs and hit that homework, huh?
Okay. Thanks for explaining everything to me. I think I feel better now.
I wish we did.
I don't believe this.
Problem, George?
There's not one thing on AIDS in this whole stupid encyclopedia.
George, this edition was printed in 1957.
Yeah, well, we should have planned ahead.
Look, we discussed all this and we agreed. Wesley's perfectly fine. There's nothing to be concerned about.
Hi, I'm back from the library.
You find anything out?
Yeah, I got a couple of real good things from the Department of Health. Look, it says right here that not one identified case of AIDS infection is known to have been transmitted in the school or daycare setting or through other casual person-to-person contact. And look, here it says, of the 229 cases of pediatric AIDS, there's not one instance of a child infecting his parents or siblings. And that's a family living together.
See? And you two were so worried.
Well, come on, Belvedere. You were just as worried as we were.
That's ridiculous.
I'll get it. Hello? Just a moment. Mr. Belvedere?
Yeah?
It's the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta. They're returning your call.
Tell them it's all right. I'm over my cold. Getting rid of the evidence?
You work your fingers to the bone, you try to make a decent meal for your family, they don't appreciate it.
Kevin, that wasn't such a bad dinner. Just that we were all a bit preoccupied with Wesley and his friend.
Yeah, I know. It's just I take this dumb home ec class for the easy A. Turns out it's just one more thing for me to screw up.
You'll do better.
What do you think I should do with a meatloaf?
Go deep.
Hey, Mr. Belvedere.
Hello, Wesley.
Here. It's a $5 bill.
Oh, thank you. Is this a gift, or do I have to keep quiet about something?
No, see, there's a picture of Lincoln on it. I figured it might help you for when you're making my costume.
Oh. What's the matter with Danny's costume?
I just don't want it.
Now, Wesley, you've talked to your parents. You know there's nothing to be afraid of, right?
Yeah, I know that.
Then what's the problem?
I don't want to lose all my friends. I mean, Danny doesn't have any anymore. If people find out I've been hanging around with him, pretty soon I won't have any either.
Wesley, you mustn't let what other people think or say.
I don't care what you say or do. I'm never going to see him again.
All right, Wesley. Up to you.
Anyway, I guess that means you're not going to make my costume, huh?
No, no. I'll take care of it.
You will?
Mm-hmm.
Gee, thanks.
Come back.
Kevin, I have a little job for you.
Is this supposed to be a joke?
Well, if it isn't Honest Abe.
What's going on? I don't look like Lincoln. I look more like Soupy Sales.
All right, Wes. Looks pretty good.
An excellent job, Kevin. Just what I had in mind.
Thanks, Mr. Belvedere.
Sharp.
You let him make my costume?
It seemed the thing to do.
Mr. Belvedere, it's terrible.
Oh, now, Wesley, let's not be hasty. As far as I'm concerned, you can't tell a thing without the hat. There. Perfect.
Lincoln would never wear a hat like this.
He would in Tijuana.
Mr. Belvedere, my pageant's in 2 hours. Where am I going to get a real costume?
I don't know. There must be one someplace.
Hi.
Hi.
Came around back like you said. I don't think anybody saw me.
Good.
Anyway, here it is.
Thanks.
Hope it fits okay.
Don't worry.
Well, I'd like to stay, but I really should get going.
Bye.
It was nice being your friend.
Look, I don't like doing this, but I gotta watch out for myself. Anyway, don't get mad at me. It's not my fault you got AIDS.
It's not my fault either. Anyway, you better get ready for your pageant. Be a good Lincoln.
Hey, wait.
Yeah?
Wanna come?
Huh? Come where?
You know, to the pageant.
I'm not allowed.
We'll sneak in. Just like that time at the movies when we snuck out of Bambi and saw Porky's. Yeah!
Hello, I'm Franklin Pierce, the 14th President of the United States. I served from 1853 to 1857. Among my significant achievements was opening diplomatic relations and trade with Japan.
Ooh. There must be some steel workers in the crowd.
Did we miss anything?
Just the first 14 presidents.
Oh, good.
I'm James Buchanan. I was the 15th president of the United States. I was the first president to receive a telegraphic message by underwater cable. I never married. But I'm sure I dated.
Wesley's next. I know that.
Hello, I'm Abraham Lincoln, the 16th president of the United States. In 1863, I signed the Emancipation Proclamation because I believed in freedom and dignity for all men, and that's why I wrote this speech. 67 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation. Wait a minute. I can't do this. This is Danny O'Neill, and he was supposed to play Lincoln, but he couldn't because he's got AIDS.
Hey! What are you doing out here?
Dennis, get away from him!
Hey, what's wrong with you people? He's not gonna hurt you. Besides, he feels bad enough without everybody trying to make him feel worse.
You have anything to do with this?
I'd like to think so.
Anyway, now Danny's gonna do the Gettysburg Address, and everybody's gonna listen. Go ahead, Danny.
What's the matter? I don't know the Gettysburg Address. But I remember something else Abraham Lincoln said before he was president. And I guess I remember it real good. Because sometimes I kind of feel the same way. If the good people, in their wisdom, shall see fit to keep me in the background, I have been too familiar with disappointments to be very much chagrined. Thank you.
Okay, let's go.
You go ahead. I just want to sit here for a minute.
Oh, okay, I'll sit with you.
Kind of feels like we're out fishing.
Yeah.
You know, we could really go if you like. I can get my dad to take us.
Have you ever been fishing?
You haven't? Hey, I got an idea. We can make a list of all the stuff you've never done and then go and do it.
That's an awful lot of stuff, Wesley. I don't know if I'll have time to do it all.
What do you mean?
Wesley, Danny, everyone's waiting in the car.
Oh, okay. We better go.
I've never been to Gettysburg.
Oh, yeah?
Being Lincoln's, I think maybe we should go.
Yeah, it's great there. I mean, we can go around and look for old bullets and sit on the cannons, and you'll be the north and I'll be the south.
Sure you won't be afraid to do all that stuff with me?
Why should I be? You're my friend.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Belvedere.
It was worth it. I'm just back from Gettysburg. Danny and Wesley had a wonderful day, then insisted we swing by Funland in Harrisburg. After all, it's only 70 miles in the wrong direction. But it was worth it, because we all got to break the world's record for most consecutive turns on the tilt-a-whirl. According to Wesley and Danny, they now only have 2,763 more things to do. I suppose at this point, I should write something profound about life and death. Do you know something? I'm really not in the mood.